Hello everyone, Jizo here. Today I decided to add another entry to the bestiary. This time we're going to be discussing a mythological creature that originates from Scottish folklore, known as a Kelpie. Kelpies, according to the legends, are water-based creatures that appear at sunset, most often than not near secluded forests, lakes, pools, or rivers. The goal of a Kelpie, as weird as it may seem, is to find companionship in any human that may come across one of the beasts. But don't let this fool you. Kelpies achieve this so-called companionship in a very morbid way. As I stated before, they usually appear near bodies of water in the form of a horse. And as many tales of folklore go, they appear as the most beautiful version of themselves. Kelpies are said to be really tall, well-built horses with either white or black skin and a dripping wet mane no matter how long they stay on dry land. Kelpies are also said to have a sort of magical trance to them. Just being in the surrounding of one or even catching a passing glance is enough for one to be entranced by them. From this, you would be compelled to get closer to the beast, tempted to pet its mane, then without realizing, jumping on the back of the creature itself. If you find yourself in this situation, it's essentially too late for you at this point. The trance will be broken, revealing the Kelpie's true form. You will see a creature that resembles a horse, but is far from it. The Kelpie's once shiny skin and long beautiful mane is replaced with decaying waterlogged skin that has gaps in the skin that reveals rotting internal organs. From this, one might think that their best option is to resist the Kelpie, kick and scratch at it, or maybe even jump off its back. But unfortunately, that won't work. The Kelpie's skin and mane at this point will be just a collection of viscous, rotten flesh, holding the victim in place. As for fighting your way out of this, I wouldn't advise that either. Kelpies are known to be extremely strong, resilient creatures, having enough strength to challenge 20 horses alone by themselves. From here, after the victim has worn themselves out completely, the Kelpie will then slowly walk to the closest body of water, dragging its newest prey down with it. Oh. The Kelpie's not exactly done at this point either. For a while after the victim's death, the creature will keep them fused to it, personally absorbing more and more of the person until they're completely gone. When this happens, the Kelpies reappear as they always do, waiting for another human to repeat the cycle. Now, it's not all doom and gloom. Kelpies, according to the tales, have one weakness, that weakness being metal. Even the smallest amount, such as a metal necklace, will save you if you're foolish enough to get close to a Kelpie. Along with its weakness to metal, there is said to be a way to where you could take control of a Kelpie. To do this, you need to get close to a Kelpie, and then remove the saddle that lays on its back. And apparently by doing this, you enslave the Kelpie to you and your family for generations. Apparently many castles that were family owned in Scotland were built by using enslaved Kelpies. Even today in Scotland, the Kelpie is still seen as a sign or representation of strength. Many statues and decorations around Scotland, well, they appear as Kelpies, and some even see them as guardians, which is a tidbit of the lore of the Kelpie itself. Many think that Kelpies only appear as horses and their main goal is to just drag you down to the depth to feed off of you, but actually, a little bit of the lore that I left out was that Kelpies can transform into pretty much anything that they desire. One side of the lore says that Kelpies appear as a very burly and tall or handsome man that lures in young women, and using a trick of wiping a tear off the cheek of that form, the woman is then enslaved to the Kelpie for life. It is said the only way to break this curse is that if you caught the Kelpie transforming back into its original form, that being a rotting, decayed form of a horse-like creature. But the only way to do this, or to catch a Kelpie transforming in this way, is waiting for sunset, when the Kelpies naturally have to return to the water. See, Kelpies share something with another beast, or yokai, known as a kappa. They both share the same goal of grabbing you and dragging you to the bottom of the ocean, but in the case of a Kelpie, when at sunset, their form shifts back to the original form. They cannot stay transformed for the whole time. But besides being a man, they can actually transform into a beautiful woman, sharing traits with another creature known as a mermaid or siren, which they pretty much are. And the male form isn't just used for attracting women. It's actually used for killing those that find the true form of the Kelpie itself, such as grabbing you, picking you up off the ground, and either snapping your back with a vice-like grip, or slamming you head first into the floor so hard that your neck shatters. All in all, just like every other folklore and mythological story told from the past, I think the Kelpie's up there with one of the most interesting ones. It's a humble story teaching children to stay to themselves and to not go close to bodies of water, due to the fact that many children end up drowning. But as always, I put my thoughts at the end of the videos, and I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I know it's been a very long time, but I plan to start the Beastiary series back up again, for it to be my main focus, while the anime tidbit of me talking about them is more of a side story thing. Well, that's gonna be it for me. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe, if you want to, it's free. Leave a comment telling me how you guys felt about the video, and I will see you next time. Later. Lost in the wind without nothing to my name.